Hey everyone, welcome back to episode 106. This is the cross-country flight across the USA. You remember in episode 105, we landed at Sullivan Regional Airport, not too far from St. Louis. Today we're going to pick it up from there. We're going to head west towards Tulsa, Oklahoma. So it's about 270 miles between airports, so not a huge flight. We're going to set up our GPS real quick. Looks like a beautiful day to go here in Pretend Land. So let's get our altitude. Let's get ourselves 270 miles. It's a little less than an hour. Not a real long flight, but if we get up in the air, let's get ourselves up to about 18,000 feet. So let's set our altitude to 18,000. We're at almost there. And let's raise our vertical speed. We're gonna climb out at 1,500 feet per minute. So you can see that over there. Let's set the autopilot on. We're not gonna turn the autopilot all the way on yet. Once we're airborne, I'll hit the autopilot engage button, and then we will be off to the races. So let's get out of here. Let's get up in the air. Of course, flying the TBM 930, because this thing's awesome. All right, let's go to Tulsa. Never been to Sullivan Regional, so I don't know how realistic this looks. Looks like a nice place, though. All right, we are up. Landing gear up. Pull up that click of flaps. Engage the autopilot. Let's take a look outside. Look back towards the airport. Nice. Take a couple of screenshots so we can make a thumbnail. And we're off and running. So as I keep making videos for my channel, you know, I just dabble around with a couple of different things. I love Flight Simulator because it's pretty awesome. I also like flying my drone, although the weather hasn't been great, so I haven't been up lately with it. I need to get out and shoot some more drone footage, but I have been doing a little bit of driving around and shooting some video from the car. And people tend to like, the viewers tend to like drone stuff. The car stuff's not doing too bad. Flight Simulator gets a handful of views, but I just like playing this, so I don't mind making videos, even if it's just for me someday. But the one nobody watches is Minecraft. And that's because, you know, who wants to sit around and watch a guy play Minecraft, although there are quite a few people with just tons of views for Minecraft. But, I don't know. I find it as a good way to pass the time. So this is Missouri. Let's take a look at the map, see where we are. Flew to Tulsa. I've been there one time that I can think of. I went out there for a business meeting, and I had a couple of other stops either before there or after there, but we took off from wherever, and when we landed in Tulsa, the flight attendant came on and said, "Ladies and gentlemen, none of the bags were loaded on the plane." That is the first time that's ever happened. Not a single bag was loaded at the previous airport, so I had to wait around. My stuff showed up around midnight. They actually brought it to my hotel so I could get ready for my meeting the next day, but I thought that was pretty amusing. Of all the weird things that have happened on airplanes, that's one of the tops right there. So cross-country flying, not the most exciting thing in the world. It is a nice view, though. Things trimming out. We're cruising around pretty nice. So let's start doing a little bit of math here and figure out what we need to be planning for. So I need to look up the altitude for Tulsa. So trusty phone. And we'll just say KTUL altitude. And that number is 676 feet from the Will Rogers Airport. 676, we'll call it 700 feet. So if we're at 18,000, I want to get down to 2,000, call it. I need to come down 16,000 feet. So I need 16 minutes when our estimated time hits about that 16, 17 minute mark. We'll start bringing the plane down. So we'll get up here and start cruising. Hopefully we can get up around 300 knots. It's not going to be a long flight. Although right now the ET is just over an hour. But we're going to make up some, we're going to be cooking in a few minutes. Alright, we'll sit back and relax and watch the view. Oh. All right, we're just about at our altitude, almost 18,000. You can see the speed starting to come up as we level off. Look over here on the right side of the screen, up to 250 knots ground speed. You can tell up here with our estimated time, it's really clicking down fast because we're going, you know, really gaining a lot of speed here. So we're down to 48 minutes, it's cruising still. Take a little while for that to level out. 267 knots ground speed, 270. So when we get down, what did I say earlier, 16 minutes left or so, we need to start bringing it down. However, we can get a little more speed out of it if we go a little higher. Let's see if we can get it up to 300 knots here before it kind of slows down. 284 almost.
Tampa City Center, Cotty 129er is at flight level 350, descending 10,000 feet.
County 129er,
Kansas City Center, continue as planned.
We're cooking, 289 knots. 291. Alright, let's go up a little bit more. Let's raise it up to 19,000. Get up there quick. We'll bleed off a little speed as we go up. You can see the ground speed clicking down, but we're going up pretty fast here. Let's take a look outside. Lost quite a bit of speed. It's coming back for true airspeed, 285. Speed's 290. Not bad. About to have our 300 knots, 301 true airspeed, ground speed's 299. It's not too shabby. 197 nautical miles to go. There's our 300. About 39 minutes. Still counting off a little better than a second at a click, which means we're still making up time. Let's just enjoy the ride. Let's see if I can figure out what road that is down there. What interstate? So where we start, we started from Sullivan, just outside of St. Louis. Straight shot, more or less, over to Sullivan, or to Tulsa. Pull up Google Maps. Guessing that's 44. Oh yeah, it's got to be 44. We go through Joplin, Springfield through Joplin, right into Tulsa. south of St. Louis. I'm sorry, south of Kansas City. If you ever go there, you gotta go to Jack Stack and get some of that cheesy corn and some burn-ins. I'm telling you, that is some good stuff right there. And I know KC is full of great barbecue places. When I go there, I tend to stay near Jack Stack, so it's really convenient. If I don't have a meeting or a dinner meeting or something, I'll shoot over there and meet a friend. Man, that's good stuff. I miss eating out with people. I had a weird dream the other night, but I shook somebody's hand. Got to get through this pandemic, man. Really looking forward to that. Getting back to some form of normal. I like being home. I'm not traveling so much for business, but at the same time, there's something good about that too, getting out with people and customers. Well, gives me some time to play around on YouTube. Maybe make some new friends, so when this thing breaks up, somebody else can show me a good barbecue joint. Thanks for watching. All 10 of you. Like I mentioned before, I shoot these videos at night after everyone goes to bed. Today is no different. The day I am shooting this video is November 6th. I'm sure that's the date. Yeah, Friday, November 6th. It is 11 p.m. Just waiting on the election to be called. Some slow counting, man, in Nevada. You think out there, all the casinos, they can count fast. They count the money fast. It's okay. Take it slow, get it right. I'm looking up at the TV just to get an idea of what's going on. Nothing. Nothing's changed. Alright, cruising at 19,000 feet. Headed towards Tulsa. Making good time. We have 33 minutes to go. We'll start descending. 15, 20 minutes, something like that, 15 minutes or so. Bring it down for a good landing, I hope. My last couple of landings were sloppy. I'm bouncing it, man. I'm hitting the ground a little hard. Maybe today's my day. Coming up on the Springfield Airport there. You can see it down on the lower part of the screen. From outside, get a good view of Springfield. Springfield and Branson, Missouri. Never been to Branson either. I'll tell you what, when all this travel stuff ends, man, I am getting on the road. I am ready to roll. I don't care if I have to sleep in a tent. And travel and see this country. It's great. There's so much to see and do. I cannot afford a $4 million airplane I'd have. So let's get that straight. Now, if you can go get me a couple hundred million views, I will spend it on an airplane. If I can get enough, I'll learn how to fly it. And then I'll go wherever you want. But for now, I'm stuck with the flight simulator. That's more my spot, my speed, my price. Maybe that's the deal. If I can get enough followers to monetize this thing, I will buy an airplane. And I will video everything I do in it. It'd be awesome. I'd also like to have an RV. I'd drive that sucker all over the place. Kids are doing schoolwork remote. Might as well pack them up and go, right? Check a couple other things on the instruments here real quick. I was gonna look at the torque, it's fine. All this is good, no red lights blinking anywhere. The only thing I really have turned off in the game is fuel, because I don't wanna run out. But as far as overstressing it and causing damage and crashing, that's all turned on. I don't get a lot of help from the game. I want it to be somewhat realistic. I think it's a little harder to fly than a real plane, because I have a single monitor set up. What I have here on my desk, I have a 43-inch monitor, so it's a big honking monitor. And there's no room. My desk is built into a little cubby. I should take a little picture of it and paste it in one of these videos. I don't have multiple monitors. It'd be cool if I had the whole wraparound thing. And maybe that'd be a neat thing to do. I could hang some monitors on the sidewall. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna take a picture. Paste it in here. So as I lean back, there we go. Yeah, that's a crappy picture. Let's take another one. All right, so if I paste this picture up here, we'll be able to show. And if I put monitors on the sidewalls, which would be really weird, I don't know how that would work for work. I suppose I could put spreadsheets on them. Boy, I'd be nerdy as hell. I can look over here, look over there. Huh, maybe I'll do that. I'll have to do some measuring. I wonder if that would work. I don't know, then I'd have a wraparound cockpit, then I could fly this thing a little bit better. I could see around. And I just don't know how awkward it would be for work-related stuff to have monitors on the sides. Maybe it'd work. I could slide some stuff around. I don't know, thought for another day. Let's see where we are. 25 minutes to go. All right, I'm gonna turn the video off for a minute, take a drink of water, and watch the world go by. Thank you. All right, still making good time. We're down to 20 minutes, 102 nautical miles to go. So we are in the neighborhood. Turn down the engine just a little bit there. Cruising at 304 knots. A little air traffic off to the right. What is JLN? Joplin? Perhaps? Let's look it up. KJLN. Joplin Regional Airport, Joplin, Missouri. Alright. So we're under 100 miles now. Excuse me. 302 knots, 19 and a half minutes. We're going to start bringing down the altitude here. We want to come down 17-ish thousand feet. So we need 17 minutes to get the plane down. That'll put us right on top of the airport, pretty darn close to it. So maybe we need to start bringing it down now. So let's set it up. Let's start to adjust our altitude. You'll see that changing over here where we've got the 19,000. So if you pay attention to this, I've got my stream deck set up to get it up there to see the controls, or to get it in front of the camera. The cord's not long enough. So what I'm going to do is I have a button that lets me start adjusting the altitude. So I know the airport's around 700 feet. I can't fly down to 700 feet because I'll hit the ground. But if I get down to about 1,500, 2,000, something like that, then I'll take over the controls. And let's just go to 1,800 feet. I'm going to toggle it to the vertical speed setting. And we're going to start coming down. 1,000 feet per minute. There we go. So you can see that indicator here. We're coming down 1,000 feet per minute. We want to come down to 1,800 feet. So that's going to take us approximately 17 minutes. So we're going to creep on down to the ground. Where were we? 19,000? Yeah, we started at 19,000. We're coming down to less than 2,000, so 17,000 different, roughly tough. So yeah, 17 minutes. It's going to put us right over the airport because it took me a little longer to set that up. Let's go out. Let's watch the world go by. Flying man. I think it's awesome. Plan ahead. Set your autopilot. The plane does a lot of the magic. The pilot's just here to keep it under control when everything flies and when it hits the fan. I took flying lessons many years ago, a couple of different times, and it just amazes me. It's incredible the way these companies have it all nailed down. It's good stuff. All right, let's enjoy the view. We'll watch the plane continue to descend. See you on the ground. Clicking stuff. I'm not cheating. We're flying this thing real time, man. We are going to fly across the country in real time. I'm not speeding up the clock. So if it says it takes an hour to get somewhere, we're taking an hour to get there. I'm just clicking on different buttons on the screen. Can't wait to get to South America. It's going to be some big distances there. Then we're going to fly across the Atlantic over to Africa. I've got this thing kind of mapped out, although it's a little spotty and change my mind where we're going to go next. But I didn't have Tulsa on my map originally. It seemed like a cool place to go. When I flew to Tulsa that time I mentioned where my suitcase disappeared, man, I could see Tulsa off in the distance. It was awesome. Downtown Tulsa, the circle around it. It was really a neat looking town. It was a great place to visit. I just wasn't there very long. Just like a day. I stayed all night in a hotel, went to a meeting, and then flew out of there, back to Chicago. I've got a friend, a coworker that lives in Tulsa. I'm going to go visit him when this is over. Go hang out with him a little bit by mistake. All right, down to 15,400. Flying towards the ground. Alright, so we are less than 10 minutes to the airport. 43 miles to go. Think about that. So 43 nautical miles, let's just call it miles to keep it easy. If I ever go to my office again, it's 30 miles away and it takes over an hour because of traffic and all that kind of fancy stuff. I'm going 42 miles in 9 minutes. That's the way to travel right there. That's pretty awesome, isn't it? Let's keep trucking along. Let's get this thing ready to land. Once we get close to the airport. So are we still on time? So we have 8 minutes to go. We're 8,600 feet. We're going 1,000 feet per minute. I think I want to go a little bit faster down. So let's knock it down to like 1,200. We'll descend a little bit faster. Let's check our speed. I'm going to look over here on the right side of the screen. It's the same display here and here. Pilot and co-pilot get the same screen. So when we get into that hashed red and white, that barber pole looking thing, we're going too fast. So we're cooking 282 knots across the ground. We're at 265, 267 is our maximum speed. That's when we start tearing wings off and crashing and ruining everybody's day. So right now we're descending at a pretty fast rate, but it's still really doable. And we're cruising into Tulsa. It's looking good. So we're going to be on the ground in 7.5 minutes. So what I'll do is we get a little closer. I'm going to turn off the autopilot. I will turn my view inside the cockpit because I don't like to cheat. I want to look from the inside only. I don't like looking from the outside. And we're going to land. And that'll be the end of this episode. We'll figure out where we go next. I'm serious. If I get enough views, I'll buy this airplane. We'll go fly anywhere you want to go that it's capable of. You know, I probably can't really fly it across the Atlantic. Not across from Argentina to Africa. I don't think this thing has that kind of range unless you cheat with the fuel like I'm going to. The right thing to do would be, I guess, fly up north, go through Canada, way north, loop over into Europe. Or maybe to keep the game real, when I get down to South America, maybe I'll have to switch over to a 787 or something like that. It's not something I'm used to flying, so it'd be a heck of a learning curve for me. But it would be a lot of fun all the same. Something that could actually make the flight. Because I do intend, when we get to the Grand Canyon, I really want to fly around and explore a little bit. I'm going to downgrade the plane to something that's really slow, open cockpit, tons of window, open doors, no doors at all, so we can just go do a little sightseeing. So that's really what I'm shooting for here, is to get through Tulsa, shoot a little further west. I want to get to the Grand Canyon, maybe fly through Arizona. It's just a beautiful area for a Midwest guy. Seeing the desert and places like that is mind-boggling. It's cool. All right, where are we looking here? We're 6 minutes away. It's 27 miles, 27 nautical miles. We're doing great, down to 5,000 feet. So I'm going to be back in just a minute. We'll put this thing on the ground. So this is cool. So here we are. We still have quite a ways to go, but check this out. I'm going to put my mouse up here. I hit my control key. It makes that circle. You can see the runway lights. So we know we're at where to head. And we are still 23 miles away. So if it was dark, just think how well that would be lit up. That'd be something to see. Take the map out a little bit. I'm pretty confident that's KTUL. Let's look at the map. I want to get a heading or an idea of which way the runway is going. So what we're going to do is we're going to come in, we're going to follow our GPS line. We'll swing out a little bit to the south, and we're going to land right over here. another thing I cheat on is I cheat on the fuel. That's one thing. Second thing is I cheat on air traffic control. I don't follow it. I just do whatever the heck I want. So we are going to land west, facing west. Oh crap, I just hit the escape button. So let's get back into the game, my bad. Let's close this window. 19 miles away, 4 minutes. All right, I'm gonna think about landing. Okay, I can see the runway. It's over here to the left. I can see some lights. So we're gonna take it off of autopilot in just a minute. To go, 3 minutes. It's time to start slowing down a little bit. So I'm going to pull back on the throttle. I'm going to put in a click of flaps. We're going to get the speed way down so we can put the gear down in a minute. Almost down to 1800 feet. I'm going to turn off autopilot. I'm going to fly towards these lights on the left. I'm going to go ahead and let the GP or the autopilot get us all the way down to 1800. If you push the space bar in the game, it raises you up a little bit so you can see out a little bit better. On my joystick, I give it one click back so I can see the instrument panel a little bit. Get one last drink here. All right, autopilot's off. Still slowing down a little bit. 147 knots. A couple thousand feet. Turn the volume up just a little bit on the sound here so I can hear the plane. Run the other click of flaps, put the landing gear down, bring the nose down a little bit so I don't stall. If you watched my Detroit video, you know I was paying attention to the scenery and not paying attention to reality. Almost crashed. I'm down to 90 knots. Now it's funny when 90, you know, 100 miles per hour feels slow. Feels like I'm just creeping along. I can see Tulsa up in the distance there. I can see a few buildings. Alright, I see the runway off to the right just a little bit. I see my lights. I'm going to go out just a little further here, a little further south, and we'll turn right. Bring it in. I'm going to pan down with my camera, make sure my landing gear is down where it needs to be. And it is, it's all green. See my runway lights. Tulsa, just to the right side of that center brace on the window. Nice city. I'm afraid of tornadoes, though. I don't know about that. I definitely want a basement if I lived in Tulsa. Oh, this is looking good. 92 knots, 1900 feet. Lined up on the runway. I'm gonna let go of the stick. I'm gonna adjust my trim a little bit. Coming down a little fast, so I'm gonna adjust the trim just a tad. Line it back up. When we take off and get into episode 107, wherever I decide to go, let's do a lap around Tulsa. Hope I remember to do that. I have to get a little bit ahead. I mean, I'm not going to lie here. I've got to go pick up a kid from college. That's going to affect my video work. So I got a little bit, I have to get a few weeks ahead so I can get through Thanksgiving. And then I probably won't be going anywhere. I'm gonna decorate the crap out of this place though for Christmas since I can't go anywhere. Alright. This is winding up really nice. Just feathering the throttle a little bit here. Flying to the ground. Too much. Gas is off. Oh, there we go. I feel like I redeemed myself a little bit. That was a nice landing. Pretty smooth. All right, let's taxi off the runway. Bring the flaps up. Taxi off here to the left. We'll wrap this video up. Alright, so for all 10 of you that watch this thing, thank you. If you make it to this point, you're awesome. If you don't make it to this point, you're still awesome. You just won't know it. Alright, get the word out. Please like and subscribe. If I get enough followers, enough views, I will spend the money on an airplane. I'll learn how to fly it. I'll come and visit you. So until next time, have a great day. We'll see you soon. Welcome to Tulsa. See you later.